This was our Odroid cluster at the end of the last video. Today I'm going to be fitting the hard disk cages into the last element of our rack, in this section here. So in order to make this easy to film and to give me a little more room on the desk, I'm going to detach this end section from the main rack. Now that we have this section detached, we can now attempt to mount our hard disk cages within this area. These are the cages we're going to be inserting. We need to allow a certain amount of room underneath the cage to allow air to circulate through the ventilation holes. So the question is now, how do we mount two of these units, one above the other, within this rack? I've considered a number of mounting strategies. Each of the cages has a number of mounting holes at the side, which we can actually use to mount these to MakerBeam frames. We will do a vertical beam at the back and a horizontal beam to which our cage will be mounted. So as we will need two of these, we'll need one horizontal beam there and one horizontal beam further up. Now, since these will be mounting to here, we are limited to where we can actually position these. So we have the option of using these L brackets to mount our horizontal beam. And let's try mounting it to the side. Yeah, that might work. Right, we're changing plan here. Rather than having two horizontal beams, I'm going to go for the one horizontal beam. And we will use the corner cubes to secure it to the existing horizontal beam. And we'll be using these little slide-on nuts. And we'll need to remove this corner end so we can actually get in. And we will mount two of the corner cubes. This will allow us to screw them in to here. It's number one connected. And we just have to connect number two. And we'll tighten these up for the moment. That's then loosely tightened. Now we just have to look to see how we can connect them at the other end. Right, we are now secured on one side. That's quite secure. Now let's see how we can do the one above. Can we use the same approach for doing that one? Right, we will slide two of these small bolts into the upper horizontal. Now we position them in roughly the same position. And let's see if we can screw these in as well. Easier if we do it this way. is that screwed in? Yes, I think we have actually connected. Yeah, we now have two units mounted in on one side. We now just have to consider the second support. And we need to consider how these are actually going to be mounted. Perhaps one like that. So we'll need to slip on another set of bolts. So this one in place now. Right, let's secure these first of all. We can move that down slightly, I think. Right, so we will attach more corner cubes. This can be moved down slightly. Here's another one of these. Tighten this up. And that's that corner sorted. Now we just have to do the same for these. So just line this one up. Just have to fasten this one now. Right, that's those connected. I just have to do the same approach at the end. Right, if we have a look at this now, we can see we have two hard disk cages mounted with a gap between to allow some airflow. So what we need to do now is to mount this back into the main frame. And this will fit in here, like so. A few adjustments to make. Let's just put this on its side so this is easier to mount. And we'll connect the corner, which is this part down here. And then we'll be complete. So let me just slacken these off. So if we turn it on this way, it'll be a little easier. And I'll put it back down to fit these on. If we can tighten up these last bolts. And there we have the two cages fully integrated into our rack. Now all we need to do next is to connect the power and the SATA data connections to the back of each of these Icy Docks. However, I'm going to leave that to our next video. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.